So let's just start by sitting here without speaking. You can close your eyes or not, it's really up to you. No practice is necessary. Noticing the sounds, noticing the sensations in the body. Noticing the thoughts. And notice that you are not even doing the noticing. The noticing is simply happening out of control. No one doing it. Simply aware of what is happening, just the way it is right now. Including any ideas that it should be different, that it should be more comfortable or more interesting. Or that I'm not there yet. There's still something lacking. All these are simply thoughts happening presently. Actually, who you are, beyond all thought, doesn't lack anything. It's absolutely whole right now. Just the way it is. Life happening as this sensation of sitting on a chair, or this thought, or emotion. And yet, so often these thoughts seem to be believed in. We believe that there really is a problem, that things aren't quite good enough. We believe in a separate identity, which we call me. We believe that this me is in control of my life. And yet we know life shows us so often that we're not in control of anything. that we don't know anything. As soon as we think we know something, the reality is that we really just don't know. These are simply thoughts. The nature of thought is to try to know, to try to understand everything. And it does a fantastic job. But who you are cannot be understood, cannot be pinned down, cannot be labeled. Who you are is absolutely not known, never known. Paradoxically, it seems that we've gone through a whole lifetime believing that we are separate. And yet knowing all the time that we are not, living this paradox. Knowing right now that there is no separation other than in thought. Thought separates. Thought labels. Thought says there's a you and a me. But is it true? What we're speaking of here is stripping everything naked. Vulnerability, nothing to hide. And this is who you are. Absolute openness. Openness full. Full of whatever is happening. Emptiness. Full of this. This sensation. Or this sound. Or this thought. So the purpose, it seems, of this meeting is to reassure thought. Because thought is in a misunderstanding. Thought believes that it can help, that it can do it all for you, that it can find all the answers. Who you are doesn't need any help. Who you are is absolutely perfect already.